And we would be uploading the videos one by one, actually. So of course we'll be uploading all the videos. We won't have any bias as such, but then it would need some time as well. So today I'm going to speak on use of technology in teaching and learning, as well as use of the actually different social medias as well in teaching learning, as well as some of the activities with respect to which would be helpful for us as far as NAC, NBA and NIRF is concerned, and we can actually do it. And this is again based on my experience with few of the institutions with whom I am working with. So I'm and since I'm not a expert professional or a teacher per se, but we have been using some of these resources for our business as well as with some of our clients as well. So since all of you are typically from the teaching background, some of the resources or the information that I have been sharing, you may be already knowing if you are using those particular technologies or other sources. So this is typically in case of teaching, it is believed that what the students read, they can remember that for almost 10%. What they see, if the percentage moves ahead, what they hear, again it moves ahead. Seeing and hearing at the same time, it is almost 50% of the things people actually remember. And so beyond that, when they collaborate for something, in that case, we can remember almost 70% of the things, or how students actually use examples in learning to solve the problems. Okay. And if they actually do on their own, it is almost, the percentage is really very high at 80%. But now I remember a story, or a kind of, it's a hypothetical story or a meme about the education sector, and I would definitely like to start with that particular story. This story has been told about the city of Pune. What has been mentioned in this particular story is, there is a guy who was born and brought up in Pune. He moves to States, US, for his career, and he's there almost for 20 plus years. So he is in US for 20 plus years. After 20 years, he has an opportunity to come back to India. So for 20 years, he hasn't visited Pune. Now, what happens is, he comes to the airport and he's actually surprised to see, hey, Pune had changed a lot. He couldn't recognize that, hey, this is the same airport, which I had seen. So he sees, there are a lot of changes that have happened at the beginning, from the airport, the ambience at the airport, the services at the airport. Everything is pretty much convinced, hey, I didn't visit India. India has moved to such a level jahan pe we have global facilities or amenities now. So he is a bit nostalgic because he's back there after 20 years. So from there, he starts moving towards his college, means he starts traveling towards his college. On his way, he sees big roads, which, I mean, he can see the progress or the infrastructure as well, which has improved to such an extent that he couldn't recognize it's Pune. And again, he becomes really nostalgic. On his way, he has opportunity to see the malls, shopping complexes and all. And he says to himself, no, this cannot be Pune. I feel like I'm not in Pune. I feel like I'm in States. Now, what happens is, he decides to go to his college, and now he has changed the entire, he has actually seen the entire changed Pune almost an hour's time when he's traveling from airport to like, you know, his college. We shouldn't name the college because wo college ke naam se wo story aaya tha actual mein. But then when he goes to college, what happens is he goes to his class and he feels, no, this is the place jahan pe maine study kiya tha, because actually nothing had changed at a college level. Hum log wahi abhi bhi, he can see the blackboard, the chalk, the duster, everything as it is. The moral of the story herein is the things have changed a lot in almost all the sectors, but one of the key sector which actually has an impact on each and every sector as such is like, you know, the education sector. And probably therein we are actually, you know, kind of not in a position to make much of the progress in terms of using the technology at local level, or maybe like, you know, we are either it's not the one thing is willingness to accept the newer things, as well as then there is a cost factor as well. So what we decided is what we'll do is we'll have some of the resources which are free of cost available to everyone that can be actually used by the faculties or even the masters or the PhD students. Now, one more thing is when we discuss with the faculty members, I mean, it happens with every generation actually, that every generation has a, like, you know, every generally faculty members have a issue with the next generation. We cannot call it an issue, but that's what I would say generation gap is about, that hamare time pe bacche aise nahi the, abhi bacche sunte nahi hai, right? When we are not in a position to change, when our system is not changed, and but the other entire world had changed, then probably there is a mismatch in terms of the way we are teaching to the students and the way they are grasping it. So what we are trying to learn here as few of those tools. I think many of you may be actually knowing about these tools as well. We are going to see Google Classroom. Of course, most of us are very much aware of Google Classroom, which is again a free resource. Then we are going to see about a smart board, a YouTube channel, how to start a YouTube channel, college management systems. Some of them are really free. There is something called Google Slides, a book creator to create a book on your own at home, especially for the e-contents and all, as well as the blogger. What we are going to see is in a couple of cases, I'll be just explaining you what it is, and in few cases we'll actually go live to see how we can actually teach or use these particular resources as well. So this is all about the tools that we use. Also, before actually moving on to these tools, one thing I would like to tell is most of the institutes which are facing NAC or MBA, that point of time, one of the major issues is how to get connected with the alumni members as such. Because students ek bar pass out ho jate hain, unke paas time nahi hai, to how to get connected with them directly as such, like, you know. And we actually cannot have resources or people running running after, or like, you know, trying to get in touch with each one of them. In that case, these social media handles, actually, like having a Twitter handle or a Facebook page or a LinkedIn page or for example a blogger or Instagram page, really helps, because everyone has got some attachment to the institute, and if they see it through social media, then probably they are directly or indirectly connected with the institute. They understand what is happening at the institute, as well as they would be in a position to contribute as well wherever they can. So one of the questions is, does the institute actually, as a college or as a campus, do we use social media really very effectively in terms of Twitter handle, Facebook page, the Instagram page or YouTube channel, or blogger as such. So that is also something which can be done. And let me tell you, these have been small efforts, but which have been really very successful, I would say, in terms of getting connected with the ex-students. So with this, I would actually start with my session, and I'll of course start with a YouTube channel. And as everyone knows, all our videos have been actually posted on the YouTube channel. I'll just show you how does a typical YouTube channel work. Actually, it is a free of cost. You can start just with your Google account. You can start with your own Google Gmail account. Se aap YouTube channel pe upload karna videos start kar sakte ho. It's pretty easy task. And what you get is, I'm going to give you an insight about what kind of data you get as channel. Actually, we'll go to the YouTube studio. So when we go to YouTube studio, we would have all the data with respect to all your let's say the videos, the channel analytics, kitne logo ne dekha hai, kitne time ke liye dekha hai, number of hours, kitne likes mile hai, kitne views mile hai usko, kitna watch time hours hai. That all information you can get right here under, though this is accessible once you have a YouTube channel. Aap kisi bhi naam se YouTube channel start kar sakte ho if at all that name is available with the as a YouTube channel. And it doesn't, as I mentioned, it doesn't take anything. It doesn't require any money as such. In fact, as I mentioned in one of my presentations, if your YouTube channel is really good, you can actually earn money out of it. Of course, it is not that easy. You need to have a bare minimum, some criteria that are set by YouTube actually time to time. But then moving ahead, when you have if you work consistently and continuously, this can also happen. And this is actually protected by Google with on what is required also for the YouTube channel, because we have been discussing about IPs. Make sure that aapke khud ke videos uspe hai. Aap kahin aur se video bana ke uspe nahi dal sakte. If there are three instances of you uploading, or if there are three complaints against you for the copyright, in that case YouTube would block your YouTube channel actually. And this has happened with many of the people, those who don't understand with respect to the copyright infringement or copyright for the videos as such. Kyunki kya hota hai, हमने कोई कहीं से वीडियो हमें फॉरवर्ड मिला है व्हाट्सएप पे या फेसबुक पे, एंड वी अपलोड ऑन योर ऑन द यूट्यूब चैनल, दैट डजंट हैपन एक्चुअली. सो एंड हाउ दिस इज एक्चुअली हेल्पफुल एज अ कॉलेज, आई वुड से फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस ट्राई टू गो थ्रू द काइंड ऑफ वीडियोज और द एक्टिविटीज वी हैव बीन इन्वॉल्व इन टू, एंड हाउ इंस्टीट्यूट कैन एक्चुअली ऑल्सो डू स्पेशली ड्यूरिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ टाइम. सो one of the things that was really very live for everyone was like all the videos we tried to upload on the YouTube channel for this particular entire FTP, because when we had an initial discussion with the college, like the organizers, Pillai College, that point of time I was like videos ke jo rights hai, we want those rights and we'll put it on our YouTube channel. And fortunately the institute agreed, and I think that has helped us during this particular lockdown period as well, as the all the contents would be available for everyone henceforth as well. So what can be done? So like I'll tell you what, whatever events or conferences happen, most of the times what we are doing is we are just at times recording them, video recording them, and wo hamare archive room mein server pe pade rehte. That's what happens with the most of the videos that are ya fir aapke video making competitions hote hai college mein. All these things can be part of a YouTube channel very easily, and that is definitely going to add value because wo baad mein dekh sakte hai log. And I think as a educational institution, it is like our kind of duty to, like, you know, spread the awareness about the education. And especially during these times, if you are, all the videos are available on the YouTube channel. See, we were doing since almost 2 years for this particular channel. And let me tell you how the things changed suddenly. The moment lockdown started, suddenly hamare YouTube channel ka traction bad gaya. What happens is, it may not, maybe we were struggling for 2 or 2.5 years with respect to the YouTube channel. But then we had lot of content. What is also important is content as such. For all these platforms, content is the key. And I believe educational institutions are the right places to have the best of the content actually. Okay. And when you have the accessibility to the best of the content, I think we can use it really very effectively. And see, once these things are reaching, so fortunately the technology has access to each and everyone across the globe. All your ex-students as well can see that what is happening. All your cultural events can be put on the YouTube channel as well, right? So that is something which is, and as I mentioned, it's a free of cost task. Let me tell you, many of my, actually my entire YouTube channel has been taken care by my students or the interns. What we do with respect to this particular YouTube channel is we run lots of courses, the career guidance or counseling advice, as well as we have for example, this is the first time actually what we did is we included all the videos of the a particular program that we are part of. As Patlex, we are part of many of the programs, but then we never tried this. And I believe this is something which is really going to help us as well as the institution. Reason being ki, like, for example, all the feedbacks now would be available on the YouTube channel. Anyone can see at any point of time. And it's always good if you are providing quality education or quality in terms of teaching. Let some samples be available on your YouTube channel, which is going to help in terms of the branding of the educational institution as well, right? So this is one thing which you can do absolutely free of cost as a YouTube channel, okay? And again, I'll tell you what, when I was speaking with Dr. Lata the other day, she mentioned we have as a campus, we have a crowd of 5,000 students. Let me tell you, ma'am, content wise, this is a really big crowd. Or you ask any content creator or those who are operating in these domains, and I'll tell you what, if we presume, so it's just not about the numbers, but then we know that if we do random sampling as well, we would get really good quality of content, because I'll tell you what, actually the content quality you can have from anywhere across the world, from a small town, a village, or any of the places. So place is immaterial right there, right? So this is one thing I believe which is really essential or can be done free of cost as such, as a tool the institute can use. And I'll tell you what, definitely this is going to fetch some marks for you in your all your accreditations. If your content is, see, something, as I mentioned, something which can be seen by everyone, let your peer visiting come go through your YouTube channel before they visit you. Maybe they may be checking out what social medias you are doing. Do you have a YouTube channel? What are the contents as well? If it is already available, then probably before they reach your institute for inspection, probably they already have that thing in mind. Ki, hey, I'm visiting an institute jahan pe the content is really good, at least on the YouTube channel. Let me, once a kind of excitement had to reach there as well, right? So this is one thing which you can do as a YouTube channel. Second is Google Classroom. Many of us are using it to go paperless, I would say. Now the idea in case of Google Classroom is, what Google Classroom is doing is, Google Classroom is combining all their features like Google Drive for sharing the assignments and creating and distribution. Google Documents hai wahan pe. You have spreadsheets, slides for writing, Gmail for communication, and Google Calendar for scheduling. all these are featured. It's like a classroom, a virtual classroom, I believe, except the video part involved in that. It's a free web service, first of all. Through that, you can create, distribute, as well as grade the assignments in a very paperless way. I'll tell you what happens during the actually when you're preparing for NAC or NBA. That point of time, there is a huge amount of data which is available in paper and that you are converting into systems. If Google Classroom is allowing it to do it already in the, so aapka already kaam bahut kam ho raha hai. I think all of the IQAC coordinator would definitely agree with this, because the kind of issues they are facing in terms of generating the proper data, scanning it, or like, you know, creating e-files for that at times is really very difficult. And the data which is available 4 or 5 years back, usko aaj aap jab trace karne jaate ho, to at times you may not be in a position to actually, of course, I'm speaking in terms of those institutes which are actually, you know, like going for the first cycle, maybe, because those institutes who are already in second, third or fourth cycle, for them, these things, like, you know, either they are using it or they are actually, they have a proper system. But using these kind of things, you are actually be saving on the lot of manpower as well as number of man hours as well, because like, you know, NAC or NBA, everyone knows, like, you know, is more about how do you manage as well, like, you know, the resources. And if you are managing your all the resources skillfully, I believe this is one good option for all of you having a Google Classroom as such. And I'm pretty sure some of you may be using the Google Classroom. Like Google Forms can be used for creating the assignment, or a kind of a quiz that is possible actually, like, you know. So that way you can use the entire system of Google Classroom. Google is providing proper like, you know, channels to have or proper kind of facilities to have everything right there. Now actually, in one of my sessions, there was a question about security of the data, maybe through Google or maybe through other platforms, or maybe, like, for example, there are even concerns about the Zoom platform as well, okay, being used. But then as such, while teaching, I believe we have got less data which may have or may be a threat to the security as such as an institute, I believe. Yeah, and you need to have proper IT systems in place, of course. You need some kind of IT support as well, because what we saw today may be, like, you know, for example, like, you know, ki subah ye hua ki Swapnil ke system se hum log share nahi kar pa rahe PPT. So that may happen at times, like, you know, it may happen with us as well, right? So it's like something which we can't deal with. But then we need to have proper systems in place which would take care of the entire things as well, kind of basic systems, right? And I think that is one of the reasons we are actually in a position to conduct this 7-day webinar at a stretch without, I would say, any single technical glitch as well, right? So Google Classroom is another tool that can be really very effectively used in terms of creating, distributing and grading the assignments in a paperless way. And I think which is actually really good during this time. How does it actually work? Students can be invited to join the class through a private code or automatically imported from a school domain. Each class creates a folder used in a drive where the student can submit their work to be graded by a teacher. Mobile apps like iOS or Android, like, you know, can actually be used, as well as photos or photos be upload kar sakte, ya fir you can actually attach the assignments, share the files, and all the information can be actually accessed offline as well. teacher can even monitor the progress. See, first of all, I'm not an expert in this, but I have used some of these tools, okay? But you can actually explore it properly. My duty herein is to let you know how it can be done. And jahan pe mujhe possible tha, like I have used, YouTube channel. We have created a YouTube channel and kind of running it as well. I can't say successfully because it has not reached to a level. But then I think my duty here is to let you know, which you can explore if required, right? As well as this teacher can return the work along with the comment. These all things are possible in the Google Classroom. So this is another tool beyond a YouTube channel that can be used. Smart boards. We had an era of blackboards. Therein, I don't know if one of you remembers this. Maybe those who are of my age, around 40K as far, they must be knowing something called OHPs, overhead projectors, जहाँ पे slides होती है, उन पे marker से लिखना है, and you would be projecting those slides through a projector and then teaching. I think many of our teachers, who are senior here, they must have used overhead projector at some point of time for sure. Now, next came the PowerPoint presentations, of course. Yes. But then after that, now what we have got is something called smart boards. If you didn't have any access or you have never seen how does a smart board work like, let me take you through 2 or 3 minutes video right here, which mentions about smart boards. I think one of my clients, in fact, some of the faculty members from that particular institution from Pune, MIT College, from the pharmacy, MIT World Peace University, they have installed the smart. But of course, there is a cost involved with respect to the smart boards. But smart boards are very, I would say, innovative ways in terms of teaching as such. Let me take you through this particular video first. This is over. Let us go through this particular video, which gives us an idea about how does a smart board work actually. First of all, this is not my video. It has been shared by some third party. Let me just see if I can open it through Chrome, because maybe the Firefox would be a bit slow. Just give me a moment.
So what makes the smart board easy to use? That's simple. It has 3 unique features that help teachers deliver inspiring lessons that engage students in extraordinary ways. Touch recognition, the pen tray, and smart software. It needs touch recognition. It's the newest feature in our smart board interactive whiteboards. With touch recognition, you can accept.
I think we are not in a position to see that properly, video. But then you can actually have a look at smart boards. There are lots of smart boards available in the market, as well as there is a lot of content or data that is available with respect to the smart boards. Now, also what we have is in terms of attendance, fees, finance, the hostel management and all, there's something called college management systems, which is actually helping you in terms of managing your daily routine activities for example, admissions ke liye, fees ke liye, as well as managing the attendance, academics, exams, all the sheets, as well as your SAP, as well as the office administration. All these things are easily managed under something called as college management system. There are lots of service providers who provide college management system at a very cheap cost. जिस टाइम पे आप अपने कॉलेज का वेबसाइट बना रहे हो, दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम आस्क योर डेवलपर टू इंक्लूड अ फीचर रिलेटेड टू कॉलेज मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम एज वेल, एंड इट वुड बी, आई एम टेलिंग यू, एक्चुअली हेल्पिंग यू अ लॉट इन टर्म्स ऑफ मिनिमाइजिंग योर डेटा और डेटा कोलेशन विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू लाइक यू नो योर रूटीन एकेडमिक्स एज सच. जो हम, बिकॉज इट्स ऑल अबाउट डेटा, एंड एज वी हैव मोर डेटा कमिंग आउट, वी वुड बी लाइक, वी हैव टू गो पेपरलेस इंस्टेड ऑफ एक्चुअली यूजिंग द पेपर और ट्रेडिशनल सिस्टम. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो समथिंग विच वुड बी रियली हेल्पफुल इन टर्म्स ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग द टेक्नोलॉजी और यूजिंग द टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर आर रूटीन एक्टिविटीज. सो दे आर द कॉलेज मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम, इफ दे आर इंटीग्रेटेड इन यूर integrated in your website itself, they would be much cheaper, I believe, along with your website. But if you try to purchase it through some other platform, like there are lots of platforms. What we use is a college management system called Institute RP from a Pune based vendor. That particular system we are using for our formality related activities. But then these systems help you, for example in terms of like, you know, जैसे कोई आपको अनाउंसमेंट करना है, लाइक यू नो, जो हम लोग कॉलेज में थे तब नोटिस बोर्ड पे लगता था या हर क्लास में जाता था, दिस कैन कॉलेज CMS कैन अलाउ यू टू सेंड इट वाया ईमेल एज वेल एज SMS एज वेल, एंड आई थिंक मेनी ऑफ द स्कूल्स आर एक्चुअली यूजिंग इट. Like, you know, the big schools, they are actually using the college school management systems as well, wherein the even the parents have the access of what needs to be. Hamara bachcha actual mein school mein padh kya raha hai, kya classwork hua hai, kya homework hai, all these things. Of course, they are helping you in terms of reducing your workload. Now, another concept is book creator. I believe this would everyone would definitely love to have this, because many of us are authors, as well as especially when we are creating a e-content, that point of time book creator would definitely be helping you. bookcreator.com site pe book creator you can log in through your Google account. Let me sign in front of you actually. Okay. So it's free of cost actually, and instead of going to a designer for creating your small book, let's say 10-20 page ka koi chapter hai, like, you know, which you are creating content to be shared with your students. Now this particular book creator can actually help you creating the book very easily, and like it looks like a very professional book as such, or the content e-content for that particular file as well. Actually now this is a book, like, you know, this is something, let me start with a new book right here. So you have all those options of comic, landscape, square, or portrait. Let us start with the portrait. Okay, it's very easy, very simple as well. They have all the features available right here. Let me just take it here. Okay, what I need to add here is, actually you can import anything, any file as well right here. What I'll do is I'll import an image yahan pe, which is from the, let's say the desktop. Let me take one particular file related to this particular program only. I have this brochure, जो अपने event का brochure है, that I am trying to upload it here. Let me see how much time it's required. Now I got the brochure right here in the book format. It's getting uploaded. Now you have other options like already available different shapes. For example, this shape I am including here now. Okay. Of course, that picture is getting uploaded. In the meantime, I included this particular shape, as well as what I do is text. In text, one week FDP program at LI College in May 2020. Now done. Now I have the choice, like, you know, I can actually take this yahan pe. My pick would come here. This is something which is like, you know, jahan pe, if you want, you can have different designs as well. You can import all your pictures that you have taken as well, like, you know, in the book, as well as you can write, you can you have a pen as well to like, you know, write like this. Okay, so control z works here. Now I'll tell you what happens with the book. Now I'm done. Let's say unfortunately the image size is bigger, it's not getting uploaded right here. What we can do is we can actually read the book like this, as well as share the book, okay, or download as an ebook, or directly print as well. Now this is something. Through this, I'll tell you, in jo aap content word file mein bana rahe ho na, that would be actually in a kind of a e-content or ebook, which you can share with your students very easily. This app Book Creator, as I mentioned, is available free of cost to everyone. And I believe during this corona time, or like, you know, the COVID-19 time, definitely this is going to help each and every one of you if you are sharing the content with everyone. Of course, another thing is Blogger is something which blog is something which we have been, as a pharma literati, have been involved into blogging. We started with our blog long back. Now what we discussed is about the images, about the videos and all. But what about the actual content that is being created by the students? That we can put via the Blogger page as such. Now all our activities are, jaise aapke college ke page pe sari cheeze, event and all, ye aap publish karte ho, similarly you can do it on the Blogger page as well. Okay, and when it is Blogger, there can be subscribers as well. So this particular blog has got around 440 subscribers. All these subscribers would be actually getting the email once you post it here. Let me show you how does it actually look like and how to post it. This is also free. Go to blogger.com and sign in through your Gmail account. Now this is a Pharma Literatica Gmail account, through which all these are our posts that we have done. Of course, you have all the data with respect to number of views, when was it posted, who posted it, as well as all the statistics as well, for example. And let me tell you, ye statistics aap show bhi kar sakte ho, like, you know, to the people during your accreditation as well. For example, if you have a Blogger page, now see, I have a Blogger page and my traffic, or my audience is, let's see, all-time audience jo hai, my post jo hai total, usme India se 85,000 page views hai, US se 67,000 hai, Russia se 15,000 hai. All this data I think is really pretty useful as well, right? So this is one way. And again, as I mentioned, this is free of cost. And no one, like, you know, you can actually, it is not necessary that aap apne academics se related, kisi ka koi hobby hai, या फिर फॉर एग्जाम्पल समवन इज इंटरेस्टेड इन समथिंग विच इज the person's own forte beyond the academics as such, right? For example, किसी ने photography classes लेनी है, photography से related content है, या फिर किसी competition के essays है, you can put all these things on a blogger very easy. That's what, in fact, we have been doing as well. There is a blogger called Amit Agarwal. His monthly income using blogger is 30 lakhs. He reviews the softwares or different kinds. So if you are an expert, for example, aap kisi technology domain ke expert ho, and so that point of time, if you're one if I post something related to pharmacy college, then I may charge to that particular college as well, right? Of course, we don't charge anything to anyone as of now as a blogger, but then this is also possible. Amit Bhavani, one of the top influential bloggers. We had a session by Amit Bhavani right here in Latur as well, and we never knew that we had around 25 bloggers right here. Right. So this is the way actually you can actually put your content as well. I think that's what I have. I have actually got a couple of other things, I think, which maybe really kind of useful as well. As I mentioned, having an Instagram page, a LinkedIn page. Why LinkedIn? I'll tell you, once a student passes out from the institution or college ka jaise uska life khatam hota hai, most of them are active on LinkedIn rather than Facebook or Instagram. Reason being ki LinkedIn really helps in terms of professional growth. And I'll tell you what, many of the big universities or the institutions have got their LinkedIn pages through which they are actually trying to be in touch with all their alumni members as well. You can do, of course, it through the Twitter handles, the Instagram page, as well as the Facebook page. There have been lots of teaching learning resources or the practices that have been been used during this particular, last 1 or 2 months time. I believe platform like Zoom, my first venture was something related to, or which was directly connected with Zoom itself. Aisa hi platform banane ki hum koshish kar rahe the, but it couldn't happen. And let me tell you what, we discussed about all the problems which we faced, and none of the problem is available in Zoom as of now. We aren't facing any issue. I'll tell you one difference between Zoom and other platforms. If you have noticed, the consumption of the data in Zoom is really very less compared to the other platforms. So I'm not recommending any platform. You can take the calls judiciously, but these platforms, when they are available free of cost, I believe we can actually use them really very effectively. And I think we also have some faculty members who are from the engineering or IT sector. They can maybe help us understand more about these features as well. But then my intent herein for this particular session was again discussing something what we have been practicing or what we have been already doing, and which has been really helpful in terms of business as well as in terms of reaching everyone, as well as I would say the impact that we are making in terms of the students' career as well. So let me take any questions if we have. Thank you. There's so many good morning messages. Priya, you don't have to upload on Telegram, directly mail. Yes, thank you. Thank you so much, Shilpa, for your information. So that was about the YouTube video as a feedback which you wanted to share. Thank you, Shilpa, for that information. Now we have got one question, which is how to create free blog or free blog site. This is coming from Gurumit Vadhwa. This I think I have covered. Aapko blogger.com pe jana hai. There is wordpress.com as well. Wahan pe using your Google account, you can start with a blog. It's very, very easy. Social Jyotiraj Pathak is saying social media are essential for progress. Absolutely yes, absolutely yes. That is for sure. And in fact, like, you know, henceforth it is going to be that case, like, you know, having the social media handles for each one of you, right? You know, as an institute as well. Bharat Tupere, I would like to ask you that how do you create blog on YouTube channel? Will it be useful for my teaching my students? Bharatji, absolutely it would be useful for everyone. Each one of your student can actually go through your classes free of cost. In fact, you know what, YouTube offers you a option of premium as well. Once you have 10,000 subscribers to your YouTube channel, you can content premium, you can actually create premium content which would be available only to the only to those who pay you. So there is an option which is provided by YouTube, but that comes at a very later stage. Bharatji, it would be really helpful for everyone. Absolutely. How can you secure your YouTube? It can get hacked. Now I think Dr. Madhu, security is something that everyone, like, you know, every technology platform, be your mobile handset, be your laptop, or be it your content that is available, that has been actually like, you know, a prime concern. But I believe you need to take care of bare minimum things which would be helping you out in terms of securing the security as such. But this is absolutely true that the content may get it is very easy to hack these things as well. So what I suggest is generally, or what we also do is we can actually have those things in public domain which are just for teaching or educational purposes, rather than, and most of the people do the same thing actually, like, you know. So I mean, that can be hacked, that's absolutely fine. But then that, so for example, mobile hack ho sakta hai doesn't mean ki we stop using mobiles or the laptops, right? We need to take bare minimum precaution, I think, and which would be at least helping in terms of some of the security. We have to upload the videos as individual or as part of college. This is coming from Priya Sundar Rajan. I'm actually not sure in what context this question is. So for example, what you can do is, if you are asking in terms of the college events, I think you can upload, college usually has a Gmail account. Uski through up a YouTube channel run kar sakte ho, and you can upload it. If you are asking about today's session, so we'll be uploading all the videos actually, like, you know, feedback videos on the YouTube channel. What is the process of taking consent from the, no. Dr. Jaffrey, what is the process of taking consent from original YouTube channel owner to broadcast on my YouTube channel? First of all, I won't recommend this happening on your YouTube channel, because YouTube works on a principle that any third party can even lodge a request to YouTube that this particular content is actually not owned by this particular owner. So if you see all our YouTube videos, or most of the YouTube channels' videos, they are the original contents actually. So if you have actually original content, then only put it on your YouTube channel. So as far as consent is available, take the written permission via sending an email and all, but I think no one would be actually in a position to provide that as well. Why would someone give you a permission to have their videos on your YouTube channel, educational institution or anything. Kiran Mishra, can you do practical session how to use Google Classroom? I'm not an expert, but I can connect you with the right kind of people. What is the process of taking consent? I think Dr. Jaffrey have covered. Our college is using Google Classroom. So we got an expert here, Shraddha Ovale. Sorry if I'm pronouncing it incorrectly. They are using Google Classroom, and definitely Shraddha can help you in terms of a lecture on Google Classroom if they are already using it. RUSA has started a site for uploading the college documents, which is secure and accessible. This is coming from Priya Sundararajan. Thank you so much for this information. What kind of information is available? That can be very easily I think available from the RUSA website. Sanjay Kalekar, Google Classrooms, how they are used, I think you can get in touch with Shraddha. Shraddha ke details are there with the organizers. Melroy is saying Google Meet, which is really easy to use. That is for the classes, I believe. Yes. Prajna Shetty wants to know, how does Google Classroom work? Is there any copyright issue? Very nice. This is coming from Smita Khaire Jadhav. Can we upload YouTube video in Google Classroom? If we use, is there any copyright issue? I would say something which we have grown as a class in last 7 days, if we are thinking of copyright issues in this particular case. So I must appreciate Smita for this particular question. So I'll tell you what, copyright can be issue if you upload that video on your channel, because you'd be commercializing it. But if I do it in a classroom, live classroom, or if I do it through Google Classroom, I don't think there should be any issue, because educational purposes ke liye it is allowed. Actually, you cannot stop someone from using that particular content for educational. But if you download it, prepare a CD out of it, and try to sell to everyone, then probably there is an issue. Next. Many colleges have conducted training sessions on Google Classroom. Believe me, it's simple to use. Yes, thank you so much. Thank you so much, Vijay Shila, for your comments. And I believe Google Classroom is something is really helpful during this time. And see, if you're using it, very nice to know that. I think that's the right platform for the content. Chandrakant Dumale, yes, Google Classroom se related bahut sare hamare paas comments hai. Very nice app, Pranali Deshmukh, book creator. Just try it once. I have tried already. Okay. Do we need to have our website for blogs, Sunita Sherifani? No, not at all. You just need to have a Gmail account. Everyone has a Gmail account. Absolutely, Smita Khaire, you can add pictures as well from Google. In Book Creator. Okay. Now, Smita Khaire, again the same thing. Agar aap wo e-book freely aapke students ko de rahe ho, absolutely fine. As well as, let me show you something in terms of Google Images that you can use. There is actually an option. Agar aap Google Images search karte ho na, there is an option which images you can use and which you cannot use actually. Let me just show you how it actually works. So we are into Google Images. Let me search Pillai College. Now we are into Google Images. We would be having lots of images. Okay. Now, if you see, let me see, tools mein jao, images jab aap search kar rahe ho, users rights. Now labeled for reuse and labeled for reuse with modification, isko click karo, jo bhi images aa rahi hai, you can use it free of cost. Okay, but isme not filtered by license जो है, labeled for non-commercial reuse, वो भी actually आप कर सकते हो. Okay, so all these are features. Google Images में just explore Google Images and you would understand what you can use and what you cannot actually use as well. Now let me just go through the next set of questions. Let me. I think I have missed the some of the questions. Let me go back to the question where I was. There are lots of questions today because of the content that we had. I would say just a minute. Let me go back to the questions. Yes. Sanjay Kalekar. Thank you. Yeah. So, can we add pictures from Google in Book Creator? I think I answered this, Mita. Asrar Siddiqui is about positive and negative impact of social media. Siddiqui sahab, aisa hai ki har cheez mein, in every sector, we have good or bad things. It's up to us to decide what needs to be taken. Let me tell you, when we speak about the negative things or negative impacts, actually, one thing I would like to mention here is, frankly speaking, I have never met any of the organizers of this particular program. And actually, when I was speaking with Dr. Lata on third or fourth day, once our session started, she had never heard me, or none of the faculty members had heard me, but just through some kind of trust building, I would say, of a day or two, I would say this is a really positive thing that someone sitting in Navi Mumbai or Mumbai and I'm sitting in Latur without any connection, we are in a position to actually organize such a great concept here for 7 days. That is all what positive this particular program has got, I think. So social media ke negatives hai, we need to ensure that it's up to us to decide how to take it ahead, actually, because we would be surrounded by the negativities or the negative things. But then there are ways, actually, to find the reduce negative impacts, as you rightly mentioned, Asrar Siddiqui sir. Dr. Caroline David would love to join you a session in case if you are having one attached to any other college. Absolutely, yes, ma'am. How do we ensure the confidentiality while drafting ebooks? What we are discussing here is what kind of confidentiality. I'm not understanding this, because what we are discussing here is probably the content which is being generated for the students. Not we are not speaking about a book which need to be published in. Okay. For the students, that purely for the educational purpose, I believe. Sachin Deshmukh, very nice to see. In fact, I think we had a video as well from Sachin Deshmukh. We create book on Book Creator. Can we get ISBN number? I believe if it's an e-content, definitely you can go for it. I don't think there should be any issue for ISBN number. But it's very nice to know that, someone thinking about ISBN number as well, because now that means we have moved to a level jahan pe we need to do it professionally as well. Bhavna Mulani, Book Creator is a good one to provide notes. Absolutely, ma'am, we have used it. There are greater online tools along with social media. How far all them authentic and approved for teaching and learning? Sanjay Kalekar ji, I've tried to give you some idea about some of the tools that are available that I have used, okay? Based on recommendation or your judgment or maybe kind of reviews or feedback, you can actually have it. Based on this particular session, I believe everyone, all the stakeholders were pretty happy with the concept of Google Classroom as such. And I think at least we have, that's up to you to decide how to do that. Sandra Lopes, such a valuable information. Google Creator is really going to, yes, ma'am, that is definitely going to help you. How can get book ISBN if I'm publishing my book? I think there is an online process, you can just go through it. I think Dr. Jaffrey, I have covered this question. YouTube channel create is it best practices? Yes, Bhagwan Wagule, thank you so much. Of course, we have got a lot of comment. What is the, I think this question I have already covered about the content actually, consent actually, okay. Then we have a lots of comment. Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm just checking if there are any questions which are unanswered. Just couple of minutes, Revati ma'am. I think you are just waiting for your turn. Mostly college authorities approve of a few tools which government has consented. Yes, Sanjay Kalekarji. This is really, I would say, a call which need to be taken by you based on the, like I'll say, pros and cons or the kind of security features. And see, basically, what are you sharing with? What are you, what data you are sharing with everyone? That is more important, I believe. And government cons, I'm not sure actually, Sanjay ji, ki, whether government actually approves or disapproves these kind of tools. And so that is something which needs to be looked into, and who are these authorities actually, like, you know, because when there was an issue with respect to Zoom as well, I think what has come out is more of advisories and precautions rather than actually banning it out, right? And I think none of these tools are being banned by the government. Now, thanks. Thank you so much. Can you, Edmodo, MOOC, Shodh Sindhu, Sanjay Kalekarji, I think you can have a session on that, reason being I'm not an expert and I have never used, and I don't recommend something which either me or my team has actually used, or I would like, I would never speak on something which is not my forte as well. Thank you so much, Sanjay Kalekarji. Then we have, is the Google account and yes, Joyce Kurian, Google account and Gmail account exactly same. Thank you so much for your comment. Thanks. I hope I didn't type the name of the college wrong. I think I'm done with the. Okay, Dr. Ruksana Sultana has a very different query. Actually, I'm working at a rural college where there is a network problem, and the most of the students are from poor family, and they are dependent on tuition. They had less interest for using social media for learning, and I think, yes ma'am, I think that's a harsh truth, I would say. And as you mentioned, rural colleges mein ye issues hai, rural colleges mein ye issues hai, as well as, and not only rural colleges, but like, you know, the kind of data that is being provided, like, you know, used in this, that makes it really uncomfortable for even for people like us. Like when I'm speaking for 4 or 5 years, at times data sab khatam ho jata hai, because I have to conduct back to back sessions as well, right? So this is something which is of concern for sure. But in that case, I believe at least what can be done is using these contents. Basically, you can provide them like, you know, instead of maybe having the use of internet for downloading everything, maybe a school or college can at least provide that facility at the college level, wherein they can download at college and maybe later can would be in a position to access it as well. And Dr. Ruksana, frankly speaking, is just not about rural colleges. The issues are everywhere. And one of the reasons that my interest in my first startup, education based startup, was exactly same. Hum log Andheri West mein station ke 100 feet bahar, 100 feet away from Andheri station, we couldn't get the range for one of the networks. And that point of time, we realized probably we are ahead of the time. Jab tak data ka problems nahi solve hoga. But I think now we are heading for 5G, okay, as a technology. And definitely these things would be helping you out. And Dr. Ruksan, I must appreciate your concern, because I think all what we discuss, unfortunately, may be working for the urban students, but for rural students, I would still suggest something. maybe like, you know, this is the right time actually, like, you know, during the pandemic or the lockdown period, when we can actually come up with newer ideas to get in touch with the students, like, you know, because I think ye sare jo tools hai, these were not part of our curriculum earlier, or we were not using. Is a better kuch lesser cost pe and with lesser use of the data or technology may can also be developed very easily. I think this pandemic should be taken more as an opportunity rather than a threat, I would say. And believe me, my first session online webinar was the next day jab Modi ji ne 21 days ka lockdown announce kiya. That point of time, I delivered my first webinar. Like, you know, in my entire life, I'd attended lots of webinar, but I had never managed a webinar typically from a technology point of view. So this I believe is something which I have learned in this particular lockdown. So this may be one option. Yeah, Dr. Ruksana. So Joyce Kurian, there is no difference between a Google and a Gmail account. I think we are done with the questions. Yes. All. I'm done with the questions. I think I have got more of comments rather than the questions that I have, and I think I'm done. Just with a hope that throughout the 7 days was in a position to give you an idea about like, you know, the technology or different aspects wherein we are. Frankly speaking, all these 7 sessions are repetitions of what I have done, but not at one go. Maybe at different institutes, at different forums, sometimes at the faculty development program, sometimes for the students, and sometimes for other people as well. But there, for me also, this was a great experience, and I must appreciate the efforts, like, you know, by the organizers of the Pillai College, and also trusting in me for like, you know, for kind of taking a huge risk, I would say, on someone who don't know, and you are actually organizing an entire week's program just based on couple of talks we had, and like, you know, so. But frankly speaking, I really am overwhelmed with respect to the kind of response or feedback also I received, the calls from the principals, the professors, the IQSE coordinator with respect, and it was actually happening every day, I would say. So thank you so much. It was indeed a kind of a I would say a pleasure for me to be part of this particular session, this particular event as such. And I think meri bolne ki aadat hai, main zyada bolta hu, but I think I should stop now, and I should hand it over to Ashwini to take care of the further proceedings for the valedictory. Thank you so much.